with the 26th pick in the 2020 NFL Draft, the Green Bay Packers select Jordan Love, quarterback, Utah State.
Aaron Rodgers and the Pack are headed west, a game away from getting back to the big show.
No timeouts, and now inside of 2 minutes. Aired out downfield, and picked! San Francisco going to the Super Bowl with a big win tonight over Green Bay.
It's a little raw right now for sure, but it definitely hurts, I'd say, a little more than early in the career, just because you realize just how difficult it is to get to this spot.
He should feel disgusted, he should feel insulted, and as far as I'm concerned, if I was Aaron Rodgers, I'd ask to be traded. To hell with all of them.
And this year's AP Most Valuable Player Award goes to, drum roll, Mr. Aaron Rodgers.
Is Aaron Rodgers, you know, we make a lot of, you know, I put a lot of attention on Super Bowl rings, but does Aaron Rodgers need another one to cement his legacy?
You know what? Unfortunately, I hate to say it, yes, he does.
Toss to Godwin. He's got the first down, and this game's over. The Tampa Bay Buccaneers and Tom Brady are going to Super Bowl 55.
Aaron, I know it's a struggle to get to the stage and you had the home game, everything that you wanted. Can you possibly express what you're feeling right now?
Yeah, Bill, I'm just pretty gutted. You know, it's a long season. You put so much into it to get to this point.
Aaron Rodgers has told certain members of the organization that he does not want to return to the Green Bay Packers. And this is an issue that has gone on throughout the course of the offseason, so much so that each of the Packers' main individual decision makers, the president, Mark Murphy, the head coach, Matt LaFleur, the general manager, Brian Gutekunst, have each taken trips out west.
Do you know what it's like to come to work with your replacement? I don't know how you repair this. I don't know why you're holding on to Aaron Rodgers when you drafted his replacement. When you take a quarterback in the first round, when you trade up to get him, you told the guy that's already occupying that position, you're on borrowed time.
Last time we saw Rodgers in Green Bay, he was walking off the field after the NFC Championship game loss. Now it appears he will return with some concessions on both sides that could put a timeline on the rest of his Packers career. According to reports from ESPN and NFL Network, Aaron Rodgers and the Packers are working on a new agreement. It could very well set up his departure next offseason. The contract to be agreed upon would result in no loss of income for the quarterback, but help the Pack under the salary cap and address the issues Rodgers has with the organization.
I had to assess the situation. Not necessarily wanted to be a lame duck quarterback, especially after an MVP season, which I think you can understand. At various points, deciding if I wanted to even keep playing, but you know, the fire still burns, and I wanted to be on a football team. And we got some things figured out in the last few days, and I'm here.
Rodgers chips one in there for Tonyan. Touchdown, Packers. A 22-yard strike.
Good protection. Rodgers, a ton of time and a man wide open, and that's fouled there, Scantling.
13th play of the drive, they try to extend right here. Rodgers looks to throw, scrambles to his right. He pumps, he throws back against the grain. Adams is in, what a play! Rodgers to Adams, touchdown Green Bay.
And the 2021 AP Most Valuable Player is Aaron Rodgers.
I'd like to thank the Green Bay Packers, Mark, Brian, Russ, our incredible fan base. It's been an amazing 17 years. I'd like to thank my teammates. This is a special league that provides you so many incredible friendships that last longer than your time in the league. And I'm so thankful for the guys I get to come to work with every day, the memories, the jokes in the locker room, and going to battle with them every week.
Rodgers telling us tonight is such a special opportunity. He said, because I don't know how many more of these we're going to get. He said to us, I don't know if this is the end of a chapter or the beginning of a new one, but I've tried to enjoy every bit of it.
Kick was down the middle and good. 49ers win it. Francisco is moving on with a 13-10 win here at Lambeau, and this crowd and that Packers team is stunned.
Aaron, how would you describe how you're feeling right now after what just happened?
Yeah, I'm a little numb for sure. Didn't think we were going to end like this.
I'm going to start with you here, Stephen A. Does this loss damage that bad man's legacy?
Oh, hell yes. And it pains me to say it because we all know how I feel about who's the man that coined the phrase a bad man. That was me. You go in, and this is the thing. You lose like Tom Brady, that's one thing. You can't score more than 10 points. It's just one game in a lot of people's eyes, not mine. The bad man no longer applies.
You heard, you know, Jeremy talking about Jordan Love. What is, you know, where does he stand now as it relates to the Green Bay Packers? Do they trade him? You know, because I mean,
I'm asking. Damien's making me laugh. Damien making me laugh.
Why?
What do y'all mean? Now they gotta make a decision about Love. Look, Love. Look. Now you can hold this clipboard. You can hold this clipboard and be that beautiful practice player that we believe in you to be. Or we gonna move you if we can get equitable compensation for you. There's only two options. I mean, essentially, Jordan Love's career in Green Bay is over.
Cousins got a throw near side, caught for the touchdown, Jefferson. Play clock at one. Pressure up the middle. Rodgers in trouble, and he is sacked. It's the ex-Packers at Arian Smith. Fake. Pressure steps away. Cousins loading up. Off to get deep. Jefferson, he's got it. Inside the 20, taken down inside the 15. Cousins over the middle. How is he that wide open? Jefferson again inside the 10, lunging for the end zone. Touchdown. On the fake, pressure coming. Rodgers in trouble and he's dropped. Oh, that was a big hit.
He's got one shot at it.
Pressure coming, though. He's in trouble. Going to throw it deep. Cobb is there with Harrison Smith. And Harrison Smith is there for the interception.
You know, I'm not taking anything away from their defense, but we hurt ourselves many times, myself included. I had a lot of opportunities to score more than seven.
Here he goes. Rodgers in trouble. Looking. Ball knocked out. Recovered underneath with no time left by Green Bay. And the Giants come from behind and knock off the Packers 27-22. New York is now 4-1 with a stunner in London.
The world. He's got his signature win of his young head coaching career. A special moment that is the mentor and the student. Zach Wilson's idol comes to Lambeau and he beats Aaron Rodgers.
Head to Detroit, and the Bills head to East Rutherford to take on the Jets. And that's the way it's gone for Matt LaFleur this year. And now it's going to be 3-5 and try to pick up the pieces, a four-game losing streak.
And so the Green Bay Packers are under Matt LaFleur. I've never lost more than four in a regular season, are about to be on a five-game losing streak, and the Lions' five-game losing streak is going to end. They are going to finish.
Just takes one game, could be one quarter, one play that can alter the trajectory of a team, you know, both positively and negatively, and hopefully we make that play, that quarter, that half, whatever it's going to be this week to put us in the right direction.
On the fake, Rodgers lets it fly, has Watson, he's got it on his feet and he's in for the touchdown! Rodgers steps up, going deep, has a man, it's caught, Watson is in, touchdown Green Bay! On a 4th-and-7! On the fake, Rodgers floating, caught, touchdown, Watson again! Yards for the win. Kick is up and good! A Green Bay winner!
There's no sigh of relief. There's no weight of the world off of my shoulders. Preparation stays the same. Focus stays the same. Expectations stay the same. But it was nice to play a more complete game on offense.
He'll snap it on fourth down. Rodgers steps up, end zone, Watson, he's got it again. He is absolutely on fire, his 7th touchdown in the last 4 games, and the Packers are right back in it. Remember, the Bears also have a missed PAT and a field goal blocked in a 1-point game. It's not the first time that's happened this year. It's Watson on the end around. He can fly, and he can fly to the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Fields launches it. He's intercepted. That'll put it away. It's Keyshawn Nixon to put it on ice.
He had completed 7 straight prior to that. Second down and goal. Here is Jones out on the edge. Touchdown. And we'll make sure he was in. To finish what they started on this possession. They hand it off. It's Jones. He's got a first down. That's the final here tonight. to look to throw it. Rodgers to the end zone, has a wide open Mercedes Lewis for the touchdown.
If they go 2-0 from here, they're going to get in.
This is Nixon, who's dangerous.
Oh, here he goes! My goodness! He's taking it the distance! You talked about how dangerous he is. The most kick return yards in the NFL. And he shows it right there. He had the 94-yard kick return last week. And here he is again.
Lot to the right side. There's the pass down the middle, and it's broken up and intercepted. Off the deflection, it's picked off. Savage got blockers in front. Only Cousins is down there. He won't get him. And the Packers have a second return in the opening quarter for a touchdown. What a kickoff. What a pick.
Unbelievable. What a job by Douglas.
They're not out of it, but second and 11. Rodgers backs up the bye time to the end zone. Touchdown, Robert Tonyan. He put in good work all day. Rodgers on the run. Pump fake, frees him to the end zone for another Packer touchdown.
Rodgers, this whole team, Rich Bisaccia today, special teams is outstanding. And I think this team, they win next week, let's say, there's five in a row.
Just want to go home.
This has been playoff football for a few weeks. It's playoff football.
Our back was against the wall, we prevailed.
The battle back and be in this situation when we play this game, to play in the playoffs and make some magic happen.
The only way you can get stronger is by facing adversity.
Every play matters. Can't take no snaps off, can't take no plays off.
It's a one play, one game mindset.
Give all your energy and effort into that moment, to that play.
Season's on the line, or whenever my number's called, I'll be out there fighting with my guys.
Every home game in Lambeau has that playoff atmosphere.
Lambeau Field at nighttime.
The playoff atmosphere.
Sunday night against the Lions.
Two NFC North teams playing at Lambeau under the lights, getting the playoffs.
We hot at the right time, and time to play Detroit.
For a division game to decide everything.
We could have asked for a better situation.
We in control of our own destiny. It's going to start with us. We're finishing the season off strong against Detroit.
Everything's right there for us. That storybook ending. Got to win with our fans and Lambeau.
You better win this game. You know what, Romeo, Romeo, where art thou, Romeo? Dog, you better win. Christian Watson, you better win. Tonyan, you better win. Aaron Jones, you better win. Okay, Matt LaFleur, you better win. But nobody better win this game more than Aaron Rodgers.
The 271st and final game of this NFL regular season. No better place for it. Welcome to Lambeau Field and a must win for the Green Bay Packers and their MVP quarterback, Aaron Rodgers.
On third down, Rodgers drifting, escaping. Rodgers throws on the run, incomplete. Goff out of the pocket, taking a shot downfield, and free is Raymond. Raymond caught it down inside the one.
first and goal, Williams. To the right, to the end zone, to the lead. Detroit Lions touchdown. McGuire came back to block Hutchinson. Rodgers deep ball for Christian Watson. Down the sideline. Watson, did he bring it in? A flag is down and he caught it anyway. At the 14-yard line. 18. 13. Rodgers faking. Throwing. Back at the end zone. Lazard. Touchdown, Green Bay. The season comes down to a snap. Goff is looking to throw, and he throws it. It's caught for the first down by DJ Chark. And you can hear them from all the way in Seattle. The Lions have come into Lambeau, and they've knocked the Packers down and out.
I just don't know if it'll be the final time or not. A lot's going to happen here in the offseason, but these two guys have been through a lot. This is one of Aaron's closest friends. He has talked about it a lot. Having Randall back, he really wanted him back. We got him back a couple of years ago. And from that national anthem, like you said, Chris, just kind of think in the back of your mind. Just never know.
We have breaking news here in Kansas City, but the focus is not here for the draft. Instead, it is in New York and Green Bay.
Breaking news. Aaron Rodgers officially is being traded to the New York Jets.
The trade finally became official. What were you doing? How did you find out? What was your reaction?
I can't remember what I was doing, but I remember my agents calling me, and they were the first ones to kind of inform me about it, and just talk to them, and then, phone started blowing up a little bit, things like that. So just kind of dealing with that through the day. Talked to Matt, talked to Goody and them. So, yeah.
Jordan Love, the quarterback of the Green Bay Packers. So, Jordan, when I introduce you as quarterback of the Green Bay Packers, how does that sound? How does it feel? Have you gotten used to it yet?
Yeah, no, it feels great. This is what I've been working for. That's the moment I've been waiting for. So, yeah.
You like it?
Yeah.
So I want to ask you a little bit about sort of the last 3 years. You had a very similar start to your career that Aaron Rodgers had. He sat for 3 years behind Favre, then got the starting job. You sat for 3 years behind Rodgers. You got the starting job. Tell me what those 3 years were like, and do you feel they helped you to get to the place you are now?
Yeah, I mean, in those 3 years, it's a lot of growing and learning and just developing. And those 3 years were, very helpful. Just to be able to sit back and watch somebody else do it, be able to learn and grow your game and understand the offense and, just learn the little ins and outs that you wouldn't be able to have, starting your rookie year. So they're definitely very valuable.
What would you say was a lesson or two or three that you learned playing under Aaron Rodgers? Because it was very interesting. Rodgers never, at least from the outside, never resented you for coming in, being drafted. It wasn't your decision. So what was it like being with him, and what you learned from him?
Yeah, I mean, I just think learning from him and seeing him work every day, the consistency and how he showed up to work every day and performed on the field. But there's so many lessons. I mean, just in learning the offense, understanding the different ins and outs of protection.
I am known as optimistic Uncle Colin. I like to take the positive sides. I've tried with the Green Bay Packers to be very positive in regards to Jordan Love taking over for Aaron Rodgers.
As one former coach told me, there's no way that they would be moving on and so willing to move on from Aaron Rodgers if they didn't at least think that Jordan Love was ready.
So I went and looked at the Packers schedule, and let me tell you, I came up with 6 wins.
This man, 4-time NFL MVP. This man, new quarterback for the New York Jets. Ladies and gentlemen, Aaron Rodgers.
Yay! Week to week, the narrative can really change. It can be, you're not the guy, and this is a mistake 1 week, and the next week, you're going to be around for 15 years. And that's the overreaction of our league. And the important thing as a quarterback is just trying to keep your confidence, not kind of getting involved in bullshit. I sent him a message last night. I love Jordan. You know, he's a great kid. I would just say to the Packer fans, just take some deep breaths. You know, just trust trust this kid. He's a great kid. He cares about it. He's going to be around for a while, and they're going to get it fixed.
Here's Love. Taps it a couple times. Going end zone. Caught! Dobbs! Touchdown, Green Bay!
We've seen Aaron Jones touch the ball three times already in this third quarter.
Here's a fade. Love. Sets up, now goes back door to Jones. He's got some blockers here. Jones gets a block. First down. Turns on the speed. Aaron Jones down the sideline. Inside the 10. Four-man rush. Love. Pass Jones. In stride. Aaron Jones racing to the end zone. And he's in. Touchdown, Green Bay. Aaron Jones remains out of the game. Fumble, but Love, it bounced right to him. Now back, now throwing. He's got a man wide open. Musgrave catches it, falls down. Love, looking to throw a fade, far side. It is caught for the touchdown. And that may take us to the end of week one here at Soldier Field, where the Packers come in and dominate the Bears yet again. 38-20, and Jordan Love couldn't start it any better. Green Bay's won 9 in a row against their rival, second longest win streak in series history, and Love 1-0 against Chicago.
That was a statement. I mean, first off, the amount of pressure, the situation Jordan Love's been in, right? Taking over for Aaron Rodgers, starting a new era.
Good for Jordan Love.
Dan Campbell. This team's now on 11 of their last 14. Quick little acknowledgement there amongst the coaches.
You buying in?
Love, end zone. Intercepted. Good night. Picked off by Amik Robertson. The Las Vegas Raiders win it 17-13.
And zeros on the clock. They've called the game. That's all she wrote. And Denver has come from behind to win.
Mr. 500. 500th NFL game. As the Packers lose their fourth straight, drop to 2-5.
Guess what? Jordan Love needs time. I know this is difficult for some Packers fans to compute.
Several signs Jordan Love is little more than a backup. It's getting worse. Now everybody's got film. People have tape. He's losing confidence, and they can see what he can't do. Throw the ball down the field.
What have you thought of how Jordan's played these first 7 games?
Yeah. A little up and down like our entire offense, right? You know, I think it's been a work in progress for the entire offense. There's been glimpses, particularly in the second halves, of really good football. But we have not started very well. So I think that group, that unit as a whole, has a lot of work to do. But at the same time, I think they're kind of committed to the process, believing that that group of guys, and expect better results coming.
Just this season to find out what you have in Jordan and if he is the guy going forward?
I think we've got 10 games left. It's going to be very important 10 games. And, I think he's done a lot of really good things. Really like the way he's responded to the adversity.
The 37. Love looking deep again. This time takes a shot for Musgrave, who reaches up and makes the grab. Forming an extra man. Love's protected. Love's got Watson deep down the field. What a grab by Christian Watson. Love. Oh, two fakes, and he finds Musgrave for what might be the knockout punch on the first touchdown of the rookie's career. Reed in motion again. Love, backside pressure, able to step away. Love will throw across his body, wide open at the 30-yard line. On the run is Wicks. And a cross from Wicks. Love, Watson, open. Watson got it. Touchdown, Packers.
the longest active streak in the NFL. Is that about to end? Floating it for the end zone. Caught! Touchdown! Romeo Doubs! And the Packers fall back on top with 2:33 to go!
Start with A.J. Dillon in the backfield, but it's a fake. Love protected. Love going deep. Christian Watson, the intended receiver, and he's got it. A big play up top on the first play. Yeah, Matt LaFleur went over angry about the spot, but does not throw the challenge flag there. And the fake. Love got a man wide open. It's Kraft who's going to walk in for the touchdown. To be a third down and three. Going for the end zone for Watson. He's got it. Touchdown, Green Bay. Second and goal. Love fakes. Boom. End zone. Ben Sims. First NFL touchdown. And Lambeau Week. Love stepping up. Throwing end zone. Watson. Tonight. This was in motion. Love retreats, puts it up for grabs. Romeo Doubs hangs on at the 11. It's up. Here come the Chiefs. Pressure's on. Love throw. It's a Watson. Oh, did he catch that? He did. But there is a flag down.
And the Rams continue to struggle on these trips up to Lambeau Field. The Packers and Matt LaFleur 4-0 against McVay's Rams, 20-3 the final.
Packers are going to win it. Kenny Clark with the rejection. And Green Bay is going to hang on to a 23-20 win.
The final.
Packers win!
Green Bay Packers are a really good football
Dangerous.
Team. I was telling everybody in Green Bay to relax, but Jordan Love looks a lot like Aaron Rodgers.
What a day for Baker Mayfield and the Bucks.
Yeah, he put in a Brett Favre performance today. Came out here to Lambeau, slung that ball all over the park, was aggressive down the middle of the field, and he's the reason they won. He's the reason they came up here and got the job done. Good for him. Played his tail off today.
Most points the Bucks have ever scored at Lambeau Field.
Game, and you know we need to win that one to get up in the playoffs. I'm excited to be at home for that game and go put on a show.
Congratulations and happy new year. All right, Mike, it's quite the party down here.
See you two
Melissa. Happy New Year. Thanks. Great celebration down there. It's a Happy New Year for all the folks in Green Bay as well, and they'll get the chance to get the win at home and make it to the playoffs. Youngest team in the NFL. Why not enjoy it? Division wins are hard to come by.
How about the idea that the Packers are a really good football team, coached by a really good football coach and quarterbacked by a kid who's been waiting and is ready to pounce and has been pouncing since week 11. Week 11. Since that time, Jordan Love has 19 touchdowns and one interception.
Good chunk of the season there was, hey, he is the guy. And then it's, hey, he's not the guy. We still need to see him down the stretch, what he can do. And now it's kind of flipped back to he is the guy. Have you been surprised with what he's done over the last couple weeks here? Kind of like, you know, confirming that, hey, maybe the Packers do finally have this next guy after Aaron, and he is going to be the guy for the future?
No, I'm not. And he's playing especially the last three games, he's playing outstanding, but he's in his first year starting.
It's a crucial game at Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. The Chicago Bears about to take on the Packers here, and the Packers control their destiny. There are three teams in the running for the remaining NFC wildcard spot, and it all hinges first on what the Packers do. They win, they're in, they lose, and a Seattle victory puts the Seahawks in. If both Green Bay and Seattle lose, the Saints would make the postseason. What an afternoon it's going to be.
Now we're down to basically this game right here.
This has got holds a lot of cards. As Love on third and one wants to go up top. Looks to the end zone. The pass is on the money for the touchdown. Dontavian Wicks.
Dallas is going to be the two or the three seed, most likely.
Third and three. Pass to Wicks. And he finds the goal line for the touchdown.
I mean, this kid has really shown up. I am impressed. This is an unbelievable route.
Only an Aaron Rodgers game topped it.
2014 against Carolina.
Second and nine. Jones. The first down to lock it up.
That'll send Green Bay into the postseason with their two best games of the year back-to-back.
The oldest rivalry in the NFL, but it's the same old story now for a number of years. What a difference a year makes, and what a crowning moment it is.
Hey, man. Hey. We going to play it.
Here's Love. Pressure. Back foot throw. End zone. It is caught for the touchdown. Dontavian Wicks. Oh my goodness.
Second and two here, though. Here's Prescott over the middle.
It's going to be picked off, and no one in front of him. Darnell Savage. Touchdown.
Letting Aaron Jones run this down their face.
Fake it to him here. Love.
Back foot. Has a man wide open. It's going to be caught by Musgrave. Racing towards the end zone. He is in. Touchdown, Green Bay.
They come into Dallas, they hand them their first loss here all year, and the number seven seed.
I didn't see that one coming. The Love family didn't see that one coming. The LaFleur family didn't see that one coming. Not even the Jones family and him plus 24 tickets saw that one coming. I don't think even the most optimistic Green Bay Packer fan saw that one coming. And even the Dallas Cowboy hater, I'll even say that, even the worst Dallas Cowboy hater could not have seen this tail kicking coming. Holy smokes. The Green Bay Packers, the youngest team to make the NFL playoffs in 50 years, just strolled into a spot where no road team won. all season long? None. You can make the argument the Cowboys were the best home team this year. That young team, youngest, greenest team, they put the green in Green Bay. The youngest team in 50 years just strolled into Dallas and put the most points Dallas has ever given up in a playoff game on these Cowboys.
Come in here. The Cowboys have won 16 straight. You're the youngest team in the playoffs. You dropped 48 points. I got to ask, how loose were you guys, really?
Real loose, I guess. I mean, we came in here with the mindset that we were going to dominate. A lot of people counted us out, and, you know, we didn't care about that. We knew what opportunity we had in front of us, and made the most of it tonight.
Yeah, dominate, understatement. And I know a lot of Cowboys fans are going to be asking this, too. How were you able to score this much on that defense?
I mean, they got a good defense, but I think we got a really good offense as well.
Now what is it to come in here, do what you did, and move on, Jordan? What does that mean?
It means a lot. It's just testament to the team and how we work, compete every week, and obviously now we got a chance to go play the Niners. So obviously another tough road game, great team. So get ready for that.
Got to go back to snow now.
Oh yeah.
Go back to work. Congrats, Jordan.
Thank you.
I'm not letting defenses dictate my play call from their coverage look.
Third down. Blitz is coming. Purdy has it blocked. Floating one downfield for Kittle. He's got it. Touchdown, San Francisco. It's Love. Couple fakes. Going
wide open in the end zone. It is. Melton, as he gets the feet down. He is. Touchdown. Take a look here. Does Mellon keep his feet in? All right, he's got the ball. I think that's a touchdown.
Stay there. Play clock's winding down.
Run it up.
They get it off. McCaffrey, right side, big seam. Cut, 30. McCaffrey! Touchdown, San Francisco! It's Love. Far side throws complete. Caught for the touchdown. Tucker Kraft and the pack back in front. McCaffrey.
McCaffrey scores. 49ers in front.
Realistically, need at least 25 yards. Love. Pressure up the middle, runs away, throws across his body, and that is picked. 49ers have it. Greenlaw still up. He needs to get down. Greenlaw still on his feet.
He's got to go down.
Just go down, and the game's over. San Francisco.
And now they advance to the championship round for the San Francisco 49ers.
Line for this one is the 49ers dodge a bullet. Period. End of story.
I think it'll sting just knowing that, you know, we had an opportunity to win. We dropped the ball on that one. So it'll sting for a while. But I think, you know, we'll be able to look back on it. See some good things we did. And obviously on the offseason, just trying to work on the things that we didn't do as well and things we need to get better at. But definitely just, you know, going to get to it and attack it, but it'll sting for a while.